Hello, today we will try to install Arch Linux on my very, very old PC, and I already guess I will have a lot of trouble. So let's move on to the video. Now this PC has Windows 10, and it works very badly. Even DXDiag has difficulty opening it. Exactly 32 seconds later, DXDiag opened. Let's see, dude. DXDiag can't recognize the processor. What the hell is this? Anyway, now this calculator has 4GB DDR2 RAM, an Intel Core 2 Duo E7500 as CPU, an Intel GMA3100 is trying to be in GPU. Now let's take a little tour on this PC. Of course, since even Windows Explorer opens in 1.5 minutes, let's call this not a tour, but crawling like a snake. There is a 150GB hard disk inside, and the task manager that I opened 5 minutes ago is now opening. Anyway, I don't have enough patience. Let's move on to the installation. After inserting the flash drive, I try to enter the boot menu by pressing F12, but the damn thing freezes even when I enter the boot menu. After selecting the USB flash drive, Arch Linux does not appear. Dude, it tries to appear. Anyway, after waiting a little while, the Arch Linux boot menu greets us. Yes, you may be seeing this for the first time like me. Since the writing and reading speed of Flash is faster than RAM, it first makes us wait like this. That is, it loads the installation file into RAM. We finally got around to Arch Linux, but it only took me 10 minutes to boot up. Now God knows how many hours it will take to install it. I am installing with classic Arch install here. Let me explain it right away. I also formatted the disk as BTRFS so that I could easily take a snapshot. At first, I was thinking of installing KDE on this system, but then I changed my mind. I hadn't used the Deepin desktop environment for a long time. I decided to give it a try and selected the Deepin desktop environment in the installation. I selected pipware as the sound and Intel's open source GPU driver as the GPU driver. I could install Linux Xen as a kernel, but it's not necessary. After all, what I need is to open it. And I installed gparted. I can check if there is a problem with the disk. And finally, I start the installation by pressing install. I don't need to set a timer here because the installation speed of Arch Linux depends on my internet speed and not exactly on the speed of the computer. So I will speed up this part of the video, and we will quickly pass this part. And the installation is finished. Now I need to reboot to switch to Arch Linux. And when the grub menu appeared, I started to get suspicious because as you can see, the menu should be in the middle, while the left side is empty and completely shifted to the right. This is not a problem, but it could be a sign of another problem. I waited for 10 minutes on the black screen, but there was no click. Yes, as I said, there are problems. Anyway, Let's wait a little longer.
A few moments later.
I thought maybe the problem was in the Deepin desktop environment, so I tried to uninstall Deepin and install the KDE desktop environment instead. I went to the command line by pressing Ctrl+Alt+F1 and installed Plasma first. For this, I typed sudo pacman splasma and pressed enter, and it installed without any problems. Then I removed the Deepin desktop environment by typing sudo pacman rsn deepin. Then I checked if the SDDM service was running. No problem. The service is open but not running. For this, I tried to start the service by typing systemctl start sddm, but it didn't work. It worked, but the screen didn't come up, so I restarted the system. And again, the half-baked group menu appeared. I was going to close it again, but yes, the system started to open. My hopes came back, and I was going to start dreaming and finally say I finished your video, but... yes, ESM does not open, service does not start. Now I suspected that the problem was in the display driver and decided to remove the cursed display driver of Intel. For this, I needed to find the installed drivers of Intel, and we can do this by typing sudo pacman q grep intel and listing all the packages and then finding the one we need with grep. Then I repeat the same process that I did when I removed Deepin and removed the Intel drivers. After the process was completed, I rebooted the system, and yes, it would work. And finally, I would tell all my friends everywhere that I installed Arch Linux on the calculator. Yes, I did it. But... there was no turning back now. I was faced with a kernel crash, and there was no solution for this anymore. Either I had to redo the entire installation, or... I decided to install another distribution on my computer, but the ISO didn't boot. I don't know if there was a problem while burning it with Rufus. I wasn't very patient anymore. So I burned the ISO to USB in DD mode instead of ISO mode, and my problem was solved. Yes, I thought that Fedora was the best distribution for this complex system, and decided to install Fedora on my computer. The computer remained on a black screen again, but I saw that the flash memory was working and realized that the computer was not frozen. It was just booting slowly, and after waiting a little while, I was very happy when I saw the Fedora Linux logo. Anyway, the operating system booted without any problems, and now I'm out of patience, and I'm going straight to the installation. Since I have a standard Fedora Linux installation, I'll speed up this part of the video. And the installation took 10 minutes and 43 seconds. Is that good? Of course not. This is beyond perfect for this system. Oh my Fedora, I love you. Now I'm rebooting the system to finish the installation. And I take out the flash drive, and suddenly this damn PC starts the system from the flash drive again. And it boots in 44 seconds. To be honest, Windows 10 was booting faster than this. Now let's continue the installation and finish it. Let's see how it goes. Which is better, Windows or Fedora on this system? The installation only takes up 3.6 gigabytes of space. Very good, very good. And when it's idle, it uses 1.6 gig of RAM, which isn't bad considering it's using GNOME. Yes, the system works better than Windows 10. Programs work better and open faster. File manager, browser and settings, etc. open faster. YouTube videos and Firefox lag at 1080p but can be watched at 720p. Overall good, I liked it. And that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like the video and send it to your Linux sexual friends. Also, if you subscribe to the channel, there will be more content like this. You can write in the comments what the next distro or operating system will be. Thank you.